I don't think we actually met, but I saw this tall, fro-headed 17-year-old.
I had the fro.
Yeah, you tamed it now, but you tamed a lion.
People ask me all the time if I was mixed because I had a fro. Hey, if anybody got hair like this and you're like, please don't, let it fall.
I was asked to come into a worship school in Florida. You know, I don't know, when I was 23 or 24, you were a teenager. And I was asked to go in to sing and talk about songwriting, worship leading, and there was this guy right in the front, who was way taller than me, who still is way taller than me.
It's the boots.
Yeah, I need some boots, dude. I just remember you soaking it in. And then I didn't know, I mean, I hadn't met you, so I didn't know it was Brandon Lake yet, you know. And then maybe 15 years later, I get this text from a friend, and he says, hey, there's this guy from Charleston, and I'd love to send you a voice memo of one of the songs he's writing. He's writing these songs for his church in Charleston that are just feel anointed, they feel special. And this was like, what, 2018?
Yeah.
And it was a song called Overflow, and it said Brandon Lake on it. I was like, who's this Brandon Lake guy? And I remember clicking on it and just being so blessed by the voice I heard and the song I heard. But more so, like, just I could tell the heart behind the voice was so special. And I thought, man, I'd love to connect with this guy. It'd be so fun to meet him.
Simultaneously. So, what y'all might know or might not know is that Phil has been my hero since I was 15 years old.
And I was 16. 16 years old.
I literally, like, getting into, like, writing my own songs, I found Phil's music and I was like, man, these songs are ministering to me so much. And I tried to figure out how to write my own songs just trying to copy Phil. That's still what I'm doing today.
It's actually kind of turned around. I just need some fringe leather situation.
Hey, it's a fringe praise tonight. Can I get an amen? Hey, I'm not even trying to be that cool. It's just that. You can wear this. Yes. I would die to see you wear this. Okay. Anyways. I'm doing it. I heard this thing one time. I've heard it said that you got to imitate before you innovate. And I have imitated this man more than anybody in our industry. Not even just like as a songwriter, but also now it's just the amazing father that he is, the husband that he is, and he's truly my brother. And so my friend texted me. And he was like, hey, I'm about to put you on a text thread with D. Phil Wickham. And he knew how much he meant to me, so he was like, play it cool, man. Which obviously, I didn't screw it up too much.
And that, he just bragged on me, which is so kind. But that was 2018, that wasn't that long ago. And 2020 and 2021 almost don't really count. You know what I mean? You couldn't really get out in front of people. And so that's really only like 4 or 5 years. From this guy, Mr. Brandon Lake, just being a local worship leader, and now his songs impacting the whole world and all of us. I just want to say thank you, dude.
It would be the kindness of God, though, that
we get to do this together.
If I could do this with anybody, God knew that it would be the most special for me to do it with my longest time hero.